In this screencast, we're going to use the data table function from Excel to look at what happens if you change two variables rather than just one, as we did in the previous example. Let's say you're the CEO of a company. Your company experienced profit and sales, and you want to perform an analysis so you can estimate the profit and sales in 2011, the next year. You want to see what happens if your growth is anywhere from 1 to 10% and your expenses are anywhere from 5 to 30%. So let's take a look at Excel and see how we do this. Here's our Excel spreadsheet, and we're going to start by putting in the sales from 2010. So that equals our $1,935,000. Let's look now at our sales projection. Since we're varying both the growth and the expenses, we don't have exact numbers for these, so we're going to make initial guesses. Our growth can be anywhere between 1 and 10%. So let's say 4% here. And our expenses can be anywhere from 5 to 30%. So let's say 12%. And finally, what's the formula for our projected sales? Well, that's going to equal our initial sales plus the growth times our initial sales minus the expenses times our initial sales. We come up with a number that we're going to simplify a little, and that's what we end up with. So now the question is, how do we show what happens when both the growth and the expenses change? So in order to do that, we have to put together a two-variable data table. So let's put that one together. We're going to start first with the growth. So the growth is going to go from 1% all the way to 10%. And again, we're going to use this fill series, and this will be in columns, and we're going to go from 1% to 10% in increments of 1%. Our stop value is going to be 10%. So that's our growth. The next thing is going to be our expenses. Our expenses are expected to be anywhere from 5% to 30%. So we're going to still use our series fill. However, here we're going to fill it in rows instead of columns. And we want to go from 5% to 30%, and let's do it in increments of 5%. So here we have 0.3, okay, and we have it all filled in. Basically, what we want to do is fill in that entire table. Again, we start with, what is the formula that we need to calculate? And that's going to be the projected sales. So that equals our projected sales. And now we select this entire area and we go back to our data what if analysis and data table. So in this data table, now we have things in both the row and the columns. So let's start with the row up here. In the row, what we're changing are our expenses. So that's our 12%. In the column, we're changing our growth. So that's here, this 4%. And then we click OK. And notice now we have filled in this table. So take a look what we're able to do. We can say if our growth is 6% and our expenses are 15%, then this is how much money we would have. So this data table is a very handy way to be able to look at scenarios where more than one variable changes.